And tonight, ISIS is launching a new threat, and this time it's in the U.S. The terror group has published a hit list with the names of 100 American military members and wants followers here to kill them. Paul Burton is live in the Satellite Center tonight. Paul, where'd they get this information?
Kate, officials say it appears the group is using social media, news reports, for example, information you can gather online, and then making those individuals a target for terrorism.
The new online post is from a group calling itself the Islamic State Hacking Division. It lists 100 members of the American military giving out their personal information, such as where they live.
That's a troubling development.
WBZ security analyst Ed Davis says these tactics are dangerous and strategic.
They're saying that these are the people that you should be on a lookout for, and if you see them, kill them.
Officials say the group is using open source information to identify personnel who have appeared in news articles about airstrikes on the militant group. The group says it's posting the information, quote, so that our brothers in America can deal with you, and because the military members were part of campaigns to defeat ISIS.
It inspired them to attack our military in the United States, and I think, unfortunately, it would be not so difficult to pull off.
It's not like they have to pull the trigger. It's not like they have to finance an operation here. They're basically activating people here in the country.
The Islamic State has increasingly used sophisticated online techniques to gain attention and followers.
It's 21st century warfare is what it is. It's terrorism and conducting military operations using the latest tools.
As for those people on the hit list,
we're not quite sure what they should do or how they should conduct themselves, but they certainly have to operate with an increased measure of caution.
And the Defense Department and the FBI are working with those individuals who have been identified, and they're investigating the validity of the information. Live in the Satellite Center, I'm Paul Burton, WBZ News. Kate, back to you.
Paul.